Good afternoon. Thank you guys for coming. We're going to start out the service with page 204 in the hymnal. Rock of Ages, we're going to do first and last verse.
Freddie brought so much joy to his family and friends. Everyone knew him as a kind, friendly, funny, and loving man. He loved jokes. The legacy that Freddie leaves behind is one of faith, family, love, and peace. He will be greatly missed by all who knew him until we meet him again in heaven. That indeed is guaranteed, I think. Will be in heaven. If you have Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, without question, Brother Freddie did. He was free to share that with anyone, anytime, and then he would always have usually a story to go with it later. I want to read a passage of scripture out of 1 Peter chapter 3, verses 14 and 15. But, and if ye suffer for righteousness' sake, happy are ye. Be not afraid of their terror, neither be troubled. But sanctify the Lord God in your hearts, and be ready always to give an answer to every man that asketh you a reason of the hope that is in you with meekness and fear. I go to this passage of scripture because the first thing, other than just being a close friend and a church member, Freddie was always a witness. He wasn't just a careless witness. He didn't just have his personal testimony. He was a well-read and studied Bible man. And he read other things. And Freddie told me more than one occasion he was an encyclopedia of useless information. But he usually, in any conversation that was brought up, he had an answer or he had something to comment about it. He knew something about it. That's because he was well-read. He wasn't just retelling what somebody else had told him in a conversation. And I believe he was a student of the Word up until the day he died. He studied. Studied regularly. He taught classes at Old Union. He taught adults usually because he had great knowledge. And he had a great way of presenting it and seeing, he would ask questions that would lead you to further study. He didn't just put it out there and say, take it or leave it. He interacted with you as he taught the classes. He worked with the youth many times. He did say on one occasion, I don't like children. But I'll tell you what, after seeing all the interaction with his grandchildren, I think that was one of his jokes. And because he surely did like children, because he interacted with them very well. He was a deacon, he was a mayor of this town, he was a leader in this community, and I think all of you know that. In his timber business, he helped me two or three times. I was in school business for a long time, and two or three times we had timber to deal with as on school property, and I called Freddie first thing, asked him, what should I do? What steps should I take? And he always helped very much. He helped gain extra monies for the districts that I was leader over. Also in hunting, he was always willing to invite me to Paul's place. And one thing that I remember, there were about 2 years there, he talked to his hunting dogs a lot. He said, I have bred these dogs up to, they're the best hunting dogs that I've ever had. And, he was so proud of that. And as a matter of fact, I think that was 1 year that I did hunt with him. And Freddie was, when I first got there, way before daylight, guess who was standing on the stove cooking breakfast? It'd be Freddie. Freddie was doing it. He wasn't complaining about it, but he was talking while he was cooking. And I know that he did many times for our church. He prepared different meals, especially the meat. However, you know, we wanted it, he would make suggestions and people just kind of left it up to him. I can't sit back now without telling a story. In my early days with Old Union, that dates back to 1986. I think that was the year I first started working with Old Union. Off and on since then, here it is 2023. lot of the children, when I first got there, now are grandparents. And I see them pray in this service. But we would go places and do things as a church, had a lot of youth, and we went to some amusement park. Brother Jeff may tell me where it was, but I don't know, but it seemed like it was Hot Springs, Magic Springs. And Brother Freddie said, "Donnie, you ride with me." I wasn't big on riding with anyone. And I had forgotten this story until Jeff reminded me of it, and it brought a big grin to my face. We were sitting together, and it scared the daylights out of us. I just say, and I'll say it as a preacher, we said some words that we can't repeat here. And the thing was, you get over there, you get to the end, and then you got to go back. And I looked at Freddie and said, "Freddie, we got to go back for this." He said, yeah, we do. We were trying to figure out how in the world we could not do that, but there was. It was go back through the same thing. I think we held our lips the next time we went back through. But that was a moment that Freddie and I grew a little closer together. As we were scared half to death there for a little bit. But Freddie, the last thing I say is Freddie was a family man. And Freddie was always trying to find connections with you. And he said, "Hey, do you know any Carsons from up at Umpire?" I said, I'm from Langley. I said, "I sure do." And he said, "Well, I can't remember who was the Carson?" So he traced me all the way up to Umpire. And I said, "Fred, to my knowledge, I'm not related to any of those. So we're not cousins or anything." But he told me many times stories about the Stacy family, the Paul's place, and all the gatherings they had up there. Been fortunate to have visited there with he and all the others that go there and have a great time. It's just a wonderful family that I love dearly. And just because Freddie's going on to be with the Lord doesn't change that fact. It's good to love his friends in the Marshall family. And let's close with a prayer. Father in heaven, I come before your throne again. And I thank you, Lord, for this opportunity to speak with Freddie and the meaning that he had in our lives. I know each one of these folks here today have a special story that they could share with about Brother Freddie. But especially, Lord, I come to you on behalf of the family. Their heart breaks. He was very meaningful in their lives. He will be greatly missed. And I pray, Lord, that your spirit, your mercy and grace will fill some voids in the next few days, even this very moment. I pray for Brother Jared as he comes in a short bit to speak. I ask you, Lord, give him mercy and grace as well. Oh, Lord, you're so good. And thank you so much for your son, Jesus Christ, that died on Calvary's cross, that we, through his shed blood, can have eternal life. There's someone here today, Lord, that doesn't know Jesus Christ as personal Savior, or they're out of his will, I ask you, Lord, to burden them with your Holy Spirit, that they might make a decision this very day to accept Jesus Christ as personal Savior. They'll never forget it. They'll never regret it. And it's for that that we give thanks, knowing that Brother Freddie, in the absence from this old body, is in your presence. We thank you and we say, amen.
Dad's eulogy. Freddie, Fred, Fur, Pop, Papa Roosby, Uncle, Cousin, Friend. He was known by many names. Freddie was born in Queen, Arkansas. He He moved to Odessa, Texas for many years, and then returned with his family to Lockport, Arkansas, where he met his lifelong love, Jeannie Thornton Marshall. Freddie and Jeannie became a family of five, with Johnny, Jeff, and Gina. As long as I can remember, Dad worked in the logging business that his family established, Locksburg Timber Incorporated. As a child, I remember he would call Mom and tell her he was going to pull over on the side of the road and let me ride in the big truck with him to the mill. Man, I loved it. Another thing that we loved is when he took us to the family land in New Hope. We call it Paul's Place. You've heard it mentioned many times today. And there he instilled in us a love for land, the river, and unity as a family. There at Paul's Place, he carved his and Mom's initials in a tree by the river. And he took Mom to that tree just a few years ago, and the initials are still there. The Marshall family holds this place dear, and we are thankful for our time spent with Dad there. And oh, how my dad loved his family. He was always making us laugh, and the kids loved to do the same. Dinner conversations took to gross conversations that would make Dad sick in his stomach, and we loved it. And one of Jeff and my favorite things to do, and you'll hear it later, so don't be surprised, it's going to be awful, but it's how we would tease my dad. We would sing "Oh Christmas Tree." We do it anytime, year round, spontaneously, whenever we wanted, and for however long we wanted, but we eventually shortened it to three little stanzas. And it was, "Oh Christmas tree, oh Christmas tree, oh Christmas tree, oh Christmas tree," over and over and over, because we didn't know the words to the song. We would sing it normal, and then sing it extremely loud, and then at a whisper. He also loved it when we tell jokes when his ribs were broke. Oh, man, we would make him laugh. We were a tough crowd, but we loved it, though, and he loved it. His way of showing love was unique. He was rather fond of finger war, thumb hugs, and pats on the back. And every now and again, he would muster up a big old hug, a big old bear hug. But mostly, his way of showing love was just visiting. His kids always loved to visit him when he got home from work, whether it was while he was sitting on the porch, in his recliner, or on the toilet. He swore the latter was our favorite place to visit him, but that's when we could catch him still. So I have a few favorite family memories to share. For me and Rocker, Pop would put suckers in his overalls and give it to us. Johnny, making his rounds and visiting and seeing whose butt he needed to chew in the log woods. Mina, I am thankful to Pop for instilling in me a good work ethic. I will treasure the hours spent in his office together, the dates at Nadine's and Zebby's, and the trips to Texarkana to pick up parts, where I would talk him into getting coffee at Starbucks. Grady, some of my favorite memories with Pops were early in the morning, in his passenger seat, the smell of grease and coffee heading into the woods with him. Jeff, I enjoyed getting to visit with him on Saturdays when he'd come to town for his tamale run. Sometimes I'd take him a cup of coffee out and he'd give me a cup of tamales. He was great at telling jokes, and I always enjoyed hanging out and hanging with him at deer camp. And then there was the Marshall toehold. He liked that. It's where we grab hold of his toe like that. Can't explain it, but would really regret if I did show you. Okay, there. It didn't matter how bad an injury he had, because he'd tell you he had worse places on his eye. He also told me there were no ugly people in this world. Some were just prettier than others. Wyatt, Pop always had a good joke to tell, or something wise to crack at you. He had a freeness about him that I've always admired, and I hope to be that way too. My favorite memories with Pop are riding around hunting with him at Paul's Place. Allie, I am so blessed and thankful that Pop married Caleb and I. In the middle of the ceremony, Pop paused for a second and said, "Psst." I said, the vows. Say the vows. Caleb, my favorite memory with Pop was a few days after mine and Allie's wedding. Pop said, I was about to reach over and slap you because you made me cry. Miley, his brisket and barbecue sauce. Hudson, I will miss his jokes. He always had funny jokes. Gina, I will miss his stories and his jokes. Saturday tamale visits and texts and calls. Johnny, I could write paragraph after paragraph of all the things I loved about my dad, Freddie Marshall. Or as he would always say, what's left of me. But to simply sum it up is that he was the best man I've ever known. I will love and cherish the time I had with him always. Dad loved his rounds. He loved making rounds, his visits at Eastmar, Wilkerson's, Bumper to Bumper, Suttle's Equipment, and of course the tamale guy at the Queen Courthouse Square. He would buy tamales and provide his personal delivery services to his kiddos and Aunt Al and others. And although he loved those tamales, he loved the visits that they brought with his family even more, most of all. He loved cooking, smoking meats, and gathering around the table with his family. He made the best barbecue sauce ever. Dad loved it when you brag on his food. Even if it wasn't the best you'd ever had, you'd better say it was anyway. Comments from friends and family, words to describe Freddie Marshall. We want to thank each and every one of you for the comments that you made to us. They did not go unnoticed. Here are some I gathered from you. I'm so glad he was my friend. Such a good man. Special person. Great guy. I had great respect for him. Wonderful man. Loved visiting with him. I loved Freddie. Loved him aggravating us. Always so kind to me. That smirking grin of his was the best. Full of personality. Respected me. Amazing human. Sweetest. Kindest. Christian man. What a legacy he leaves behind. Will be missed by many. Dad had lots of lifelong friends and extended family. It is evident in the space that we feel today to honor the memory of such a strong man that he had a legacy of love, family commitment, friendship, kindness, laughter, and peace. He was our peacekeeper. It is without a doubt that God aligned everything in the universe before and upon his passing. Dad did whatever he wanted to do right up until the last moments here on earth. Mom and Dad now got to go have lunch with him. And then he was headed to do what he enjoyed most, according to Tony Lynn, which was working, driving, and wrecking. He drove right into those pearly gates of heaven, where he is telling jokes and making his rounds with loved ones, friends, and Jesus. What a glorious and awesome day for Freddie, Fred, Fur, Pop, Papa Ruski, Uncle, Cousin, Friend. Thank you.
But because of God's goodness and His grace, He does.